could tell Morocco.
Shut up!
You're real good, that Sonic kid.
Yeah, is everyone here? Including Larry Queen?
Yes.
Alright, yeah, well, Maggot, you know what to do.
Let's do a roll
okay,
call.
Okay, okay. Dream! Maggot!
Yep.
Oh my god, Maggot.
You're the one who asked for the roll call! Oh my god!
I'm sorry.
Do you wanna start over?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, okay, okay. Dream!
Me.
George!
I'm sadly here.
I'm sorry for your loss. Sadnap here. Larry King, the B movie version. Okay, fine. I guess I'll read it again.
George, please let me see the kids, said Dream.
What kids, said Dream Not Found? Confused. I said them wrong.
Yeah, no crap.
Dream didn't answer, but instead screamed inwards. He had married George last week, but George already forgot. And now Dream was already practicing for when they would be divorced. Without realizing, as Dream screamed inwards, he created a black hole with his vocal cords. Not unlike the one George created in his heart. Every time he made Sapnap a grilled cheese without telling him, this is foreshadowing.
Yes, yes.
Same thing with the metaphor.
Well, this sports game sure is fascinating, George said as he watched National Geographic, completely ignoring Dream as he squirmed in agony.
Dream, I'll save you, said again, oil of Morocco, not sponsored, who no one had noticed until they had burst out of the event like a dick imposter they were.
Double C.
Oh.
Argan Oil of Morocco, and yes, you have to say the full name each time, pulled down a large yellow banana and stabbed Dream in the stomach with it, injecting the black hole into the atmosphere and through the roof.
Dream, said George.
George,
said Dream.
Argan Oil of Morocco, said Argan Oil of Morocco.
Okay, can you say that again, but like really sad?
Argan Oil of Morocco, said Argan Oil of Morocco.
Why did he just get sultry? That's not what sadness is.
Sad and sultry, what's the difference, eh?
I feel like you have a warped understanding of emotions.
Oh my god.
We don't have insurance!
I thought you were actually concerned about the fact that a black hole burst through my throat as a direct result of you forgetting our marriage, but yeah, okay, yeah, insurance, sure, said Dream.
Argan Oil of Morocco pressed their pointer fingers together nervously as a couple quarreled.
You don't have an insurance? Ooh.
Why is Argan Oil not Argan Oil of Morocco?
Well, I forgot, okay? Okay, refuse, I'm not perfect, okay? I make mistakes.
You said it has to be said with the full name.
Fine, I'll type it in, and you can reread it, okay? You're that picky, goddamn.
Oh, Morocco.
Shut up!
Ooh, I almost meant to say a cuss word. You're real good, that Sonic kid.
So at this point, they had two options. Remain frustrated or write about their frustrations online.
I started really crying.
As he spoke to Larry King on show that the B version of Larry King has.
Welcome to my hit show. You are not the father, said Larry King.
Dream in the audience clapped. Everyone clapped. Oh.
Dream, are you ready for the results?
OMG, yes, I was born ready.
Larry leaned over and whispered into Dream's ear. Dream's eyes widened.
Okay, mister. I appreciate you getting needlessly involved in my harem, but how is this supposed to help us with our roof?
George, you should remove all your clothes. Maybe then I won't divorce you, said Dream.
Where is this going?
I would remove my clothes for you, Dream.
There was an awkward silence as Dream made a direct eye contact with absolutely no one.
Anyways, could you explain one more time why, George, I would remove all my toenails with half a pair of safety scissors just to see you with your socks off. Was not funny.
Yeah.
No, just say that whole paragraph again.
Okay.
Paragraph? What?
You have a weird George, idea of a paragraph.
George, I would remove all of my toenails with a half pair of safety scissors just to see your socks out. I don't know about that humor, Spacie.
Ew,
but,
no, I just imagined that. And that was,
okay, fine. Okay, so I see that we have differences in taste of humor.
Anyways, George, I would buy a million V-Bucks just to see you with your socks off.
George thought and decided he would sacrifice his dignity, as if it meant getting closer to getting that sweet, sweet insurance. He hooked the edge of his fan, slowly pulling his sock off.
The crowd gasped.
Time stopped.
The argan oil of Morocco existed. Then the FBI dropped in from the roof. The crowd screamed in terror as the FBI waved their fat yellow large fruit in the air.
George, look out, said Dream, jumping in front of George.
Dream, look out, said Argan Oil of Morocco, jumping in on top of Dream.
The stage four bent beneath the pressure of Dream, George, and Argan Oil from Morocco's thick booty. Than all three of them to fall through the floor. Larry King watched them fall, but the second they disappeared from his sight, his lack of object permanence prevented him from giving a damn.
The three friends, lovers, the three people in each other's nearest vicinity plopped onto the underground world that was Larry King's basement. Okay, Dream, George, it was Sapnap.
Crawling out of the darkness and nibbling on the last of his reserves, the grilled cheese George made him 6 days ago. Who is this oily guy? Said Sapnap, pointing to the human-sized talking bottle of argan oil from Morocco.
So I'm Dream's boyfriend.
I don't know who this talking bottle of oil this is. I don't know how it found us. It's been following us for weeks. Please help us, Sapnap.
Aha! So you guys are looking for the insurance! Said Sapnap snugly.
Sapnap and George tried not to look too much at the argan oil. Morocco wrapped his hands around Dream's neck and slowly began licking it.
Now, how would you want me to say this?
So, do you have insurance? I thought we never got any.
You guys didn't, but I did. Only problem is I can't give you any benefits unless we are family, said Sapnap, because that is how the government works, I think.
Thirsty argan oil of Morocco off him and stood up.
Sapnap, it's time I finally tell you something.
Gasp.
Dream, no.
They knew what was going to happen. They heard what the Larry had whispered.
What the Larry?
By the way, the FBI were still raiding Larry King's show. It's just that no one cared enough to derail the plot. Anyways.
Didn't you just derail the plot?
You wasn't here, Pidge. You wasn't here, you little
Sapnap.
Dream grabbed Sapnap's shoulders and pulled him closer, licked Sapnap's forehead, and looked him dead left in the nostril.
Wait, it's dead in the left nostril.
Shut up. No, it's not. No.
I had to deliver the line. Hold on. I am your father.
Dream, you can't just force me to be your son for insurance.
Then Dream nay-nayed him in the end.